raised by no one. Caution waves will never find home. Caution lifts, we do this wrong. Caution has the way, and I don't feel this anymore. Watch the city fall, sigh so low. Watch the sunlight and watch it go. Watch the storm rise. Watch the storm fall. Watch the storm rise. I watch the storm. Pursuing sin, life. pursuing wind, when we were forcing dreams. I can hear but I cannot see. I'll never be free. But I'll never be free. Always plagued by what I can never be. So pious and biased, like light shining down on me. I was lost for me. I was tied to me. I'll never be free. I'll try, but I'll never be free. Instrumental on the face of dawn, nothing to gain, the middle is gone. I would wait for things to die. So hard we tried. I tried so hard. Haven't figured anything out. Left behind so much pain, so much doubt. I'll leave worlds behind. I'll never be free. I was plagued by what I can never be.
Oh,
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And thank you all for coming out tonight. Hi. I honestly, because I'm old, can't remember the last time I played a show like this in New York City. And it's like amazing, but also disconcerting to come back to the city where I was born. At present, I don't live here. Well, here's what happened. I got sober and in an instant realized that like New York is paradise for drunks. I mean, there's no better place in the world to be a drunk. And if I relapse tomorrow, I move back tomorrow. But coming back here and like, I mean, I was walking up First Avenue and I realized the first time I went out in New York and got drunk was 1979, walking up First Avenue. So now it's like, I'm like this old ghost. And this is a song that I wrote. What song are we doing? Oh yeah. I wrote it in 1992 as a huge techno anthem. But don't know, you're jumping the gun. Because as a techno anthem, it was terrible. And so, but I sort of held on to some of the vocals and then a few years later turned it into a very sweet little ballad. Does my heart feel so bad? Why does my soul feel so bad? Why does my heart feel so bad? Why does my soul feel so bad? Why does my heart feel so bad? Why does my soul feel so bad?
Ears open doors.
So I have to ask this simple question. Is everybody having a nice time? And so the reason we wanted to play here in this lovely, beautiful, small venue was to mainly play songs from the album I just released, but also because I'm not a complete sadist, we thought we'd play some older songs that people might be familiar with as well. Thanks. Thank you. Free.
Oh, in this darkness, please light.
Thank you. driving refrains. I can't see, I can't speak, I can't walk, I can't talk. I can see how it's falling apart. There was a time when we were held in above, and to the falling when we're dying for love. Question for the man doing the lights. There's this fan back here. Can I move it somehow? We could turn it off. You can turn it off from up there or down. Because it's a little odd to be playing before a blizzard and have this freezing cold air conditioning fan blowing on my back. Not to be whiny and complaining, but it's a little odd. So, this next song...
I love you!
Thank you, that's nice to hear. So this next song is a song that I wrote right before I got sober. Not to make it all about... It's not an AA meeting. Hi, I'm Moby, I'm an alcoholic. But I was listening to a lot of John Lee Hooker, and there's this particular period where he wrote a lot of really dark songs. There's one called I Hate the Day I Was Born, and it's just super dark. So this is me, white Anglo-Saxon Protestant kid who grew up in Connecticut, somehow
cautiously and hopefully respectfully trying to channel that dark ghost of John Lee Hooker. It's a song, it's on the new album, but this is a version that doesn't sound anything like the song on the album. That's helpful, right?
Come on.
Thank you.
Later, I wanted less but nothing greater. I couldn't leave, I couldn't stay, sir, like a motherless child.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I
thank you, thank you, thank you. So, thanks. So at this point, so this is the point in the set where we walk off stage, but we are going to work under the assumption that if we were to walk off stage, you would ask us to come back. Thank you. I guess that was sort of begging for a compliment, sort of a leading question if I, but so this next song is a song that, boy, it was a weird point in both my life and the life of the music business. We spent, and I'm so ashamed to say this now, we spent $950,000 making the music video for this next song. No, you shouldn't cheer because that's shameful. And it got played once because it was terrible. $950,000 for garbage. Like, we could have bought a town in West Virginia. And but then the song ended up getting used in all the Jason Bourne movies. So it, luckily, it had a life past that pointless, stupid waste of money video. Thank you.
What?
Well, thank you, thank you, thank you. So I haven't asked this in a while. Is everybody having a nice time? Okay, that's good. How about you nice people up on the balcony? Yes? Okay. Not nearly as enthusiastic as the people down here, but that's fine. That's called tribalism. I was gonna go further with that, but we all know where it ends up. So this next song is, there's this one little bit of trivia. There's only one thing that I'm aware of that Jimi Hendrix and I have in common. Well, we both play guitar, that's one thing, but clearly, like, he was a legend and he invented all these sounds and different types of music and genres. But there's one thing we have in common professionally is both of us had one and only one top 10 single here in the United States of America. So this next song, and it's funny because some people, every now and then I'll have someone come up to me and say like, oh, I love that song because it was my feel-good jam. And I was like, you do know it's a song about a post-apocalyptic future wherein like morals and values have ceased to have any meaning. And they're like, yeah, you know, summertime.
Here we are. nobody know my troubles but God. Don't nobody know my troubles but God. Ooh, Lord, am I troubled so high? Ooh, Lord, am I troubled so high? Don't nobody know my troubles but God. Don't nobody know my troubles but God. I went down the hill other day, so got happy and stayed all day. I went down the hill other day, so got happy and stayed all day. Oh Lord, am my troubles so high? Oh Lord, am my troubles so high? Don't nobody know my troubles but God. Don't nobody know my troubles but God. Oh Lord, am my troubles so high? Oh Lord, am my troubles so high? Don't nobody know my troubles but God.
Song that's not on the set list. This is a cover song, and it was written by Willie Dixon, and then it was made popular by the contemporary rock and roll group Led Zeppelin. And there's one and only one issue, is that Led Zeppelin did not get permission to cover this song, and as we live in a litigious culture, Willie Dixon claimed tortious interference on the part of Led Zeppelin. Can you tell when I use fancy lawyer terms that I'm from Connecticut? And he sued Led Zeppelin, and he took the money, and he started a school for underprivileged children in Chicago, which is such a beautiful story, especially because it's such a dirty song. So I just love that this, like, this dirty, dirty song funded underprivileged education in Chicago. Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
You need cooling, and honey, I ain't fooling. I'm gonna send you back to school. See, now, way down inside, honey, you need it. I'm gonna give you my love. I'm gonna give you my love. Hey, I want a whole lot of love. I want a whole lot of love. I want a whole lot of love. So you've been yelling, and honey,
I'm assuming all of you need it, right? No? Moby, you don't need it? You're good? No love? All right, cool, whatever.
I'm gonna give you my love. Every inch of my love. I want a whole lot of love. I want a whole lot of love. I wanna hold out of love. I wanna hold out of love. I wanna
Thank you. So, why are you yelling? Indoor voices. I'm a white Anglo-Saxon Protestant from Connecticut. We don't yell. Yelling makes us uncomfortable. The only time we yell is like birth, maybe one sexual experience, and then when the Dow plummets. I mean, you're with me, right? New York 2018. So, speaking of New York, this next song is the very first song that I ever released, and one of the first times I ever performed it. I mean, back then, performed it meant like I would play a dat and jump around like an idiot. But the first time that I ever did that was actually here in Brooklyn. And this is going to be a super obscure reference that I'm guessing one or two of you might remember. Does anyone remember the Storm Raves? No. Okay, there was this promoter, DJ, producer named Frankie Bones, and he had Storm Raves. And it was the first time I'd ever really been to Brooklyn. Like, we took the L train, like, way far away. And it was amazing. This was back when, like, I mean, I was paying at the time $120 a month rent. New York was filled with artists and musicians, and you could have a guy like Frankie Bones who rented a warehouse somewhere in East Williamsburg, and like the police didn't mind, and there were people smoking crack, and it was no big deal, and they played techno, and everybody was happy. And this song, it was the first time I ever played this song. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. So, last week, as some of you might know, Stephen Hawking died. And he was one of my heroes. And this next song, see, I never met Stephen Hawking, but he had a cameo on The Simpsons, and he seemed like he was funny, in addition to being a genius. So I'd like to dedicate this next song to the memory of Stephen Hawking, and I hope that up in quantum mechanics heaven, who knows what happens in quantum mechanics heaven, but I hope that up in quantum mechanics heaven that he would be amused that I would dedicate a disco song about quantum mechanics to him posthumously. Thank you. Stop us now, 'cause we are all made of stars.
Yeah, people that come together, people that fall apart, and no one can stop us now, 'cause we are all made of stars. We are all made of stars. We are all made of stars. We are made of stars. We are made of stars.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. So now, this next song is the actual last song of the entire set. And when I say that, I don't mean that in a disingenuous, show-busy sort of way. Like, this is the actual last song, because we don't know any more songs. And I know usually in showbiz, a band or a musician, you end with, like, your big, crazy, loud song, and then you say, thank you, good night, and we're not going to do that. What I thought is we would play this very quiet, kind of obscure, delicate song, and I have this idea. I know that we're all tough, hardened New Yorkers, or at least I used to be before I moved to California and became a complete Southern California cliche. I go hiking, I'm a vegan, I meditate, I do yoga, been sober, I talk about feelings. I also ask me the best way to get from Los Feliz to Santa Monica during rush hour, and I will have opinions about that. So this last song, I have this idea that when it's done, or as it's ending, we can all sing the chorus together and walk out into snowy New York and say goodnight. And you'll see, the chorus repeats a lot. So by the end of the song, if you don't know the chorus, you're probably a Trump supporter. By that, I mean a dim-witted fucking idiot.
To turn away.
the treasure find. So
remember earlier we were talking about at the very end we would all sing this together? So here's the thing. I don't want to publicly shame anyone because you have a choice. Like, you could choose to sing or you could choose not to sing. But if you choose not to sing, that is kind of like a public admission that you lead a sad and joyless existence and that you have no soul and that, like, whatever good in you clearly disappeared a long time ago. So that's your choice, like, sing or publicly confess that you're dead inside. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Let's hear it, guys. Ready? You're good. All right, let's do it again. Here we go.
That was beautiful. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful night.